Good morning, North. Today is Wednesday, January 25th. Here's what's going on around North.
But first, could you please stand up and recite the Pledge of Allegiance?
Here are students celebrating birthdays.
Here's today's birthdays.
Happy birthday to Rusty A in sixth grade.
Have a good one and party hard.
Did you hear about the parent-teacher conferences happening? They're coming up in a few weeks.
A little scared.
Yeah, make sure your parents are signed up for that.
Hi, I'm here with Dr. Liberton. What made you come up with the CLC rally?
You know, I honestly got to give credit where credit's due. Mr. Home and Mrs. Fink had this idea. I thought they were a little crazy. I got to be honest. I thought they were a little nuts, getting all of you together in one big thing and promoting screaming and craziness. I thought it was nuts. Mm-hmm. I'm a believer now.
What's your favorite thing about the CLC rally?
Wait, hold on. Before I answer that, did I not just say that this is the brains behind this operation?
You did.
The brains behind the operation.
The
now, they will tell you what was my response when you first came up with this idea.
Mm. She said, that terrifies me. It's scary. It's a scary idea.
Why? Why would we do that?
Why?
Did I call it terrible?
Yeah, I think so.
It might be terrible.
In a really professional way?
Yeah.
Yeah, but I'm a believer now. I'm a believer. My favorite part about it? It's just fun.
Yeah.
Like, it is rare that we just get that many people together for, like, all positive, all good energy.
Right.
It's just fun.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And it's just all about celebrating you guys.
Like, I'm kind of on a high. That was a good way to start the day.
Right. Yeah.
And especially for, like, 8th graders and 7th graders, you guys have never known North having these rallies, right? So it's a good experience for you guys. When you go to high school, you're going to have rallies. So we thought that was a good way. But you also thought, like, we just don't celebrate enough of the good stuff that you guys do.
Right. Like, y'all do a lot of really good things every single day. So we thought this is a great way to celebrate. And we also really like having the whole class together.
Yeah.
There's not a ton of opportunity for that outside lunch, so it's really fun to just get everybody together.
If you could change anything about the CLC rally, what would you change?
This morning I needed 8th graders to wake up a little faster, like get a little caffeine before you came to school so you could really yell. But other than that, I wouldn't change anything at this point.
Right, I'd love to give a prize to every single person in every bucket.
That's a better answer.
But also more energy. Come on now.
But 6th grade and 7th grade is going to bring it.
Oh,
they're
going
to bring it. But I will say, when you think, like, what could we do to make it better, I actually want to get some student voice behind it.
Yeah.
So right now, it's been these are the brains behind the operation. Mm-hmm. Like, what do you guys want? You've got one or two more left this school year, so tell us how to make those rallies even better than they have been, because mm-hmm. we want to keep changing them up and make them better.
All right, thank you, guys.
I'm here with Katie, Lillian, and Stella, asking them about the CLC rally. If you could rate the CLC rally on a scale of 1 to 10, what would you rate it?
8, 5, 4.
Why would you rate it that?
It was fun. Yeah.
I had to roll a potato using my nose on the floor.
It was boring.
If you could change something about the CLC rally, what would you change?
Don't make it at 8 in the morning. Nobody wants to be peppy at 8 in the morning.
Don't make me roll a potato on the floor using my nose.
Have it at the end of the day.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Marvin, interviewing him about the CLC rally. So, what would you rate the CLC rally on a scale of 1 to 10?
7.
Oh, why did you say 7?
I don't know.
Okay, if you could change something about the CLC rally, what would it be?
More games.
Okay, thank you.
Today I'm here with Cooper. What do you like about the CLC rally, and what would you rate it on a scale of 1 to 10?
I like how everyone in your grade level is in, like, one room, and, like, I would rate it a 9 out of 10 because it's fun.
Okay, if you could change one thing about the CLC rally, what would it be?
I would change nothing. It's really good.
Thank you. I'm here with Lincoln, Taylor, and Finn, asking them what they would change about the CLC rally.
Have it once every leap year.
The kids with the lowest GPA get to get a snack.
I don't think we should have it again.
Thank you.
Hi, I'm here with Ms. Siebert talking about personal hygiene. Why is hygiene important to us since we're growing teens?
Well, as middle schoolers, with changes going on in your body, you're gonna be producing a lot more oil than your body usually does, and there's different chemicals that kind of start coming out during that time to where it makes you a little stinkier and can make your body just have an odor that wasn't always there before. So yeah, it's pretty important as far as making sure you're staying safe and healthy, and also that socially, you know, you make sure that you're not being stinky.
What are some ways that the middle school students can start doing to improve their hygiene?
Well, there's a lot of things, but the most important one would be to make sure that you take a daily shower. So, Livy, do you ever have after school activities that are like active where you might get sweaty and stuff? Right. So if you take a shower in the morning, even if you do that morning shower, if you do some activity in the afternoon, it would be really important for you to at least get washed up with some soap in all those nooks and crannies that could get sweaty, because that can be, you know, a place where bacteria can start to grow and start some body odor. Yeah, so at least a daily shower, but you just want to make sure you're always soaping up anytime you get active and sweaty too. You know what else I see in middle school is sometimes kids like to wear like a special hoodie. I have one that I like to wear often, right? But it's really important that if you want to wear that special hoodie, that you always wear an undershirt, because basically anything that touches your skin during the entire day and kind of has access to your underarms or other private places, we've got to make sure we change those every single day. So if you love the hoodie, make sure you wear an undershirt every day. Of course, deodorant, right? An antiperspirant, deodorant as well. But showering, changing your clothes, and making sure you wear deodorant, those three, if you do them every day, you're going to be lovely. You know what else? I was thinking of one other thing. Sometimes kids ask about that whole, like, I don't think I smell. But, you know, have you ever been to somebody else's house and you go, like, I kind of smell their house, but they don't smell it? That's what happens with our bodies. So, you know, you may not notice your own scent, but other people will. So make sure you do those three things. Shower daily, change your clothes, and wear deodorant.
Thank you, Ms. Siebert, for talking to us about hygiene.
Your lunch options for today are
pizza,
cheese stuffed breadsticks,
classic cheeseburgers,
strawberry parfait,
and all your usual lunch options.
Sounds good.
Yep, enjoy.
Here's our story on hallway behavior, just in case teachers didn't show you the announcements yesterday because we didn't at school.
She's a runner, she's a track star. She gon' run away.
People said that Officer Riley is safe in the hallway, so I decided to be safe in the hallway.
Officer Riley is quiet in the hallways, so I'm gonna be quiet in the hallways.
I saw Officer Riley walking with a purpose in the hallway, so I walk with a purpose in the hallway.
I saw Officer Riley get to class on time, so I
That's all for today. Scan the QR code for after school activities.